टुडे वी विल डिस्कस द एनिमल स्टमक अलोंग विद दिस वी विल गिव लॉट ऑफ फोकस टू द रुमिनेंट स्टमक The first and most important thing is that you must know what is stomach. You know, one of the basic and important thing about this topic, you know, what is the stomach? Stomach is the dilation of GIT tract. Stomach is a dilation of GIT tract, which is located. If draw stomach of any located between esophagus and small intestine, namely the first part duodenum of small intestine. And we know normally stomach produce gastric juice or some collection of enzymes which help in digestion. Stomach have ability enzymatic digestion and mechanical digestion, both abilities stomach have. They help in digestion and also perform some absorption. But when we focus on animal stomach, in specially as the eye of veterinarian, we will find in mammalian species there is great variation in the morphology and function of stomach in mammalian species. That is great variation in the morphology of stomach in mammalian species. Even you can divide animal in two major groups. These two major groups are very common. You heard this, ruminants and non-ruminants. Point is that another two terms we have, which is much clear. One is called ruminants, mean compound stomach. Non-ruminant is simple stomach. Actually, the variation in the mammalian species is that some animal have more compartment of stomachs. Some animal have more than 1, 2, 3, or 4. Some animal have a single compartment stomach. Some animal have stomach consists of only one compartment, and some animal have more than one. On that basis, the first classification, if some animal have a single compartment, we call this stomach is simple stomach. Some animal have more than one compartment. For example, if you talk about dog, cat, they have simple stomach, mean stomach with one compartment. Okay? Compound stomach, like cattle, goat, they have four chambered or compartment of, you know, maybe you read somewhere a term which is called as monogastric.
Yes, sir.
And polygastrics. You know, these terms are, people do not use this because they give a false expression or wrong expression. What? Because mono means? Single gastric means stomach. So, okay, poly mean, many, gastric mean, stomach. So, some people may think some animal have 4 stomach, 3 stomach, 5 stomach. No, this is wrong. Point is that the compound stomach is still a 1 stomach. But this stomach have 4 compartment. If you are talking about cattle, goat, typically cattle are known as large ruminant and goats or sheep are known as small ruminant, a rough terminology. So in that case, we have 4 compartment. They have different names. Rumen, reticulum, omasum, abomasum. Okay? Point number one. Listen carefully. A simple stomach or compound stomach, both are a single stomach. Difference is that simple stomach have 1 compartment. Compound stomach have more than 1 compartment. If you are talking about cattle, goat, 4 compartment. There is some, these two terms, they are giving a false expression, polygastric and monogastric. So better terms are simple stomach and compound stomach. Next, you know why this term arise, ruminant and non-ruminant? Because of rumen. Because of? So if animals have rumen, if animal have rumen in their compartment, that animal known as ruminant, and they have ability, if they have rumen, definitely they have ability to perform a procedure which is called rumination. Which is called? Rumination. So these animals, they are not able to do rumination. We will come on this again. Just first point is that compound stomach have 4 chamber. Compound stomach have 4 chambers. Simple stomach have only 1 chamber. Okay? This is, but there is a variation, especially in mammalian species. For example, if you talk about camel, if you talk about camel, so camel is, no, listen carefully. Camel have 3 compartment. Camel have 3 compartment, which they are sometimes called C1, C2 and C3. And it is generally believed that camel do not have omasum. But some books, literature say omasum or abomasum are a single chamber in camels. Point is that, but still, camel have ability to do the rumination. Camel have ability to do the rumination. They have rumen. They have rumen. Which means maybe different from the rumen of cattle and goat. Have some variations. But they still have rumen. So if somebody asks you, camel is a ruminant? Yes, it is a ruminant. But with special features. What bit? Special feature, you know, this term pseudo ruminant, sometime we will use for camel and sometime for horse, but this is also making us some confusion, because pseudo mean false ruminant, but still camel is the ruminant. Camel is the ruminant. Although they have a different arrangement of compounds. Camel have compound stomach. Okay, yes. Camel have compound stomach with 3 chamber. Cattle have compound stomach with 4 chamber. Goat have compound stomach with
4 chamber.
Both have ability to perform
rumination.
A rate of rumination is different. Large animals is also depend on food. Their rate of rumination is high. In small animal, if to compare rate of rumination between cattle and goat, cattle definitely have high rate of rumination. Goat have less rate of rumination. So that's the story. Camel also have rumination. But how will you classify horse? Horse will come under non-ruminant and simple stomach classification. Simple stomach classification. Problem is that, first thing is that horse is not a ruminant. Horse is not a ruminant. But still, horse have a single stomach, but this single stomach actually divide into two parts. Actually divide into two parts. So these two parts, because of these two parts, the stomach of horse is also special. The stomach of horse is also special with comparison to the other species. You know, if you talk an other classification, you know, because in veterinary sciences we give importance to domesticated animals, cat, sheep, cattle, horse, even camel, and also we give a lot of importance to avian species. So the avian stomach or stomach of chicken is also an entirely unique stomach a chicken have. How? The chicken stomach have is start, if you start with esophagus, you will find a diverticulum here, then you will go, you will find here stomach, further you will go, you will find here other structures, you know. Point is that this is esophagus, okay? This is esophagus. Next is, what is this structure? This is crop, a structure which store food, okay? This next portion, this is still esophagus. This is? This crop is actually the diverticulum of, diverticulum means some extension. So this crop is a diverticulum of GIT of the esophagus, okay? So here is esophagus, here is still? This structure is what? Proventriculus, okay, and this structure is have two names. One is ventriculus, other is gizzard. Okay, up to here, you know, we have lot of variation among the stomach of domesticated animals, especially on the basis of structure. If we give importance to the structure. Number one point is that some animals simply have a single chamber of stomach, which is much similar with human beings. Yes. A single chamber of stomach, which is much similar with the
human beings.
We have this kind of stomach in dog and cat. We have this kind of stomach in
dog
and cat, a single chamber. Some animal we have a stomach which is divided into four chambers. We divide it into
four
chambers. The best example is cattle and some animal we have like horse. Camel. The stomach is divided into
three
chambers. And some cases the stomach of horse is also special. This is look like a single chamber, but inside internally this stomach of horse also have two divisions.
Two divisions.
When you look on the avian stomach is a completely different. In some sense, they have two different parts. This proventriculus is a true stomach. Proventriculus is a
true
stomach. And the ventriculus or gizzard is a muscular stomach. Or a muscular, you know what, to understand this point, wait a while, we need to understand one thing very clearly. The simple stomach, a stomach of human beings or a stomach of dog and cat have three regions itself, you know. You know, and other story, and other points, two terms are much important. Non-glandular, to understand this concept, and glandular. Point is that a stomach, a true stomach actually need, you know, the wall of stomach or wall of GIT, you already know, have four layers, tunica, mucosa, tunica, submucosa, muscularis, tunica, adventitia. The first layer, tunica, mucosa, they have, and submucosa, they have some glands. They have? So these glands can produce different kind of secretions. So the true stomach have many glands. True stomach have many glands in their mucosa, and that gland can produce mucus, HCl, pepsinogen. A symbol is that gastric juice is produced by gland of stomach, which is roughly called as gastric gland, which are actually located in mucosa of stomach. So if this is the stomach of dog or stomach of human being, this have three regions. This have three regions. The first region here is, you know, the word cardia. Cardia. You know, word cardia mean what? Cardia mean a small area which is actually separating esophagus and stomach. Which is separating stomach from esophagus. Here in the region which you call cardia. You call? Cardia. Actually, this region have cardiac sphincter. Have? Sphincter, a special type of muscles which can hold, present mostly on the opening of organs. Opening of? Opening or closing point of the? Same here, out the end we have pyloric. This pyloric sphincter. So this is the opening between stomach and? But I want to tell you one thing very clearly. There is difference between cardia and cardiac region. There is difference between cardia and cardiac region. What is that different? Cardia just a structure, a area. There is, you have cardiac sphincter, a small area. This which is actually using as for the opening and closing of stomach and between esophagus. Okay, same story here. But on the basis of glandular areas, stomach can be divided into three regions. Definitely cardiac region, which is actually near to cardia, definitely, which is actually near to cardia, this cardiac region. And then we have a main area, a large area, which is fundus. This is cardiac. And last one is pyloric. There is pylorus and different between pylorus and pyloric. Pylorus mean the end point, a small area which have pyloric sphincter, which have pyloric sphincter. But this cardiac, fundus or pyloric, this is a division of mucosa. This is a division of mucosa. Because, you know, some animals, these they have little different secretions. They have different. It is believed that cardiac and pyloric, the cell located here, the gland located here, they are mostly produced mucus. They are mostly produced the secretion in this area, and secretion in this area mostly of mucus. The middle area, that area, this area, the gland located here, they are produced more gastric enzymes. They produce gastric
enzymes.
Point is that, the main point is that, the animal which have simple stomach, like human being, the dog, histologically, stomach are glandular stomach. Histologically, the simple stomach is glandular stomach. The stomach of dog is glandular. The stomach of human being is glandular. This is the main point. But when you compare this story with other animals, you will find a differentiation here. You will see within this class, if you see, okay, because horse is a non-ruminant, dog is a, but variation is here. Look here, this whole stomach of dog have whole area, whole internal, the histologically this stomach is glandular, but in dog, no, sorry, in horse, the first part, so beginning of esophagus here, the first area of the horse stomach is non-glandular. You know, if go into the deep histology, if this area is glandular, mean the epithelium is most of cases simple columnar and have some gastric pits or gastric glands are located in some mucosa and also vaginated from epithelium into the lamina propria. Here you have some special cells, cell like chief cell, cell like neck cell. Okay, they can produce mucus, they can produce HCl, parietal cells. okay, can produce pepsin. So these kind of cells located in, that's why this is called glandular stomach. If you come here, you will find a great variations. This glandular area of the horse have a special name, saccus saccicus. So this area roughly known as non-glandular area, they have a different epithelium. This epithelium is stratified keratinized squamous epithelium. Squamous keratinized epithelium. So next to this one, you will see, you will find this area is similar with the next part is the glandular part. So there is a fold which differentiation between non-glandular part and glandular part of the horse stomach. This is called Margo pellicatus. Is you simply also called a mucosal fold between non-glandular area and the glandular area. Look here again carefully. Try to understand this point. The simple stomach of carnivorous are glandular, completely. But the simple stomach of the horse, have two regions, have two areas. First one, beginning from the esophagus, this area is non-glandular. A simple meaning is that they have no glands. They have no proper glands. Okay? The next area is glandular part. So there is a demarcation between glandular and non-glandular area. Yeah. But when you go to the compound stomach, you will find here Roman reticulum abomasum. All three parts, they are non-glandular. They are non-glandular. And this your abomasum, this is completely glandular. You know, that's why maybe some books you will find this first three part of the cattle stomach or the goat stomach is known as four stomach, and the last part is called as true stomach. Listen again carefully. Yes, if you look into the camel, you will surprise. You know, this is difficult to differentiate all three parts. You know, C1, C2 and C3, they have both region. You know, the C1, for example, if we called rumen in camel, so the rumen is largely is non-glandular, but somewhere they have some patches which are glandular. So there is no clear demarcation in the stomach of camel, which area is glandular and which area is
non-glandular.
Both properties have present in stomach of camel. When you jump on avian species, there is a different story. This your proventriculus is wholly is glandular. Completely glandular. The remaining part, proventriculus, is the muscular part. A different story. You know why? Problem is that this avian species have another pouch which is known as a muscular stomach, because birds do not have teeth. For the grinding of the feed, for a proper mastication, you need some hard structure. So that activity is actually done by the gizzard.
Gizzard
in the digestive system of chickens. Clear? Listen again carefully. We know animals have a different kind of stomachs. There is a great variation in the stomach of domesticated. The first and easiest classification is that you can classify animals into the simple stomach and compound stomach, meaning that animal have single chamber stomach or animal have four or more chambered stomach. Okay, so this is another story. The third one is you look the histology of the mucosa. You look the histology of the mucosa. You will find some stomachs are glandular and some are not. But story is that the carnivorous stomach is completely glandular. In ruminants, in cattle and goat, we have first three parts is non-glandular and the single chamber stomach of horse, you know, is special. It has early first part, first area is non-glandular and last area is
glandular,
divided into two regions. Bird is completely different. They have two different pouches. First one is a glandular, which is known as proventriculus, and last one is muscular, which is known as gizzard or ventriculus. Point is that, you know, those animals who have Roman reticulum or mesem, abomasum, Roman is a root word, that's why they are called
ruminants.
If some animal is non-ruminant, that means they do not have a true Roman. They do not have a true Roman. In next few minutes, we will discuss what is the importance of Roman. Clear? And another important point, the camel stomach do not have omasum. Clear? Up to here, we have discussed some general classification types of the morphological or little functionally variation among the domestic species. Is clear?
Yes.
Okay. Now we will discuss, we give a lot of focus on to the ruminant stomach. The stomach of cattle. We will take the example of cattle, okay? Compound stomach or ruminant stomach. For this, you know, this, there is a question. Why animals have so kind of different stomach, very different structures in the stomach? You know why? Because animals have a different food behavior. Animals have a different, they eat different things. For example, grass is eaten by chiefly. Do you know, can horse eat grass? You know the difference between horse and the cattle. Horse can eat grass, but not largely. But cattle is largely, the feed component of the cattle is
grass.
Because, you know, the first chamber, which we call rumen, this have ability to the digestion of grass. We will come on, first let look on the little grass anatomy of compound stomach of cattle or ruminant stomach of cattle. Start with just little grass anatomy. Okay, so number one, if you look on, I draw a rough animal here, okay, to understand, make this first look on the this left lateral view of stomach, ruminant stomach or compound stomach of cow or cattle in abdominal cavity. So first point is that your this compound stomach in cattle are located in abdominal cavity. Abdominal cavity start from diaphragm, okay, it ends up to near, not ends actually, this is also include another cavity which is we called as pelvic cavity, which is called as pelvic cavity. Point is that if you have left lateral view, left side of animal, you are approaching
left
side animal, you will find the left side of abdomen cavity is mostly covered by rumen.
Yes, sir.
You know, we have four rumen, we have four compartment. Rumen, reticulum, omasum, abomasum. This is a basic understanding about ruminant stomach. We have already, we have four chambers. Three chambers are non-glandular. Last one is the true stomach or glandular. More other I can tell you. This rumen is the largest part. This rumen is the? This is also called as pouch. Also called as?
Pouch.
This reticulum is also called as honeycomb. And this omasum is sometimes also called as a book stomach. Or palar stomach. Lamellar stomach, sorry. And the abomasum also called as? Leave it. We will come on to this all things. Just point is that rumen is the largest part. In adult cow. Okay? Look here. If this diaphragm, there is a beginning of what? Abdominal cavity. So between the 7th to 8th ribs. Between 7th to 8th ribs are the intercostal space between 7th or 8th ribs. Okay? You will find here. If you are looking on left side, okay, like this. This will attach with up to the pelvic cavity, here. If this is esophagus is opening here, okay, esophagus opening. Left side, okay, here. You will find reticulum. When you are looking from the left side, left lateral view, you will not find omasum because left side of abdominal cavity chiefly covered by rumen. Maybe you find a small abomasum here. You will not find omasum here. Because to make this point clear, let's draw here. This is left lateral view. This is? Let's draw here right lateral view. Right? Lateral view to make it more clear. You know, this is grass anatomy is very helpful in some, for diagnosis of some diseases. If you know good knowledge, where is which part of rumen is located, how you will detect the concentration of the rumen, how rumen contracts. So this will help you. Okay, this is the left side. We need no right side. If right side, on the right side, okay. This one is a, for example, diaphragm, okay? Point is that this view is right lateral view of compound stomach. Come here. This one, this whole large area is rumen. This whole large area is rumen. Here is also this large area is rumen. This area is reticulum, which is located is lateral side or ventral side. Okay, this round shaped structure, a small structure, is omasum, not visible on that view. Okay, and this J like structure is abomasum. So this is the left view and this one is the
right
view. This rumen. Grass anatomically, you can say this is divided into some sacs. So here, grass and anatomically and externally, if you have opened the abdomen cavity here and you are looking directly onto the rumen, you are looking directly on. This is open. You just in dissection of you have opened this abdominal cavity. If you are looking on directly on the rumen, you will find rumen have large sacs, and rumen have two and other structures. You know, grass. One is rumen have grooves. Rumen have grooves. Grooves mean a depression. Grooves mean
depression.
A depressions. This is the one important point externally. And other important point, you have sacs. So this area, this, because this side is the dorsal side, so this here is the line, okay. This line is called as longitudinal groove. This is called as longitudinal groove. Because left side, okay, so you will call this left longitudinal groove. You will call this
left
longitudinal. Same story here, you cannot observe here, but this is a longitudinal groove, but you will call this right longitudinal groove. Longitudinal groove. Okay? And this depression, you know, this one, okay, this major one, this depression is known as, this area is what? Caudal buoys, caudal grooves. This is known as? Same here, this is called as? Caudal grooves, this caudal side, right side. This is called as? Here, this point here, here we have a cranial groove. Here we have cranial groove. Here we have a cranial. Because keep in mind, this is the right view, this is the left view. This is the left view. First thing, if you open externally, surface anatomy, we have grooves. We have
grooves.
So this groove is known as left, if left side, left longitudinal groove. This is known as right longitudinal groove. It's the right side, okay? And the other point, we have this what?
Caudal
groove. This is cranial groove, okay? Another thing, you know, here we have, this side is dorsal. This angle is caudal. So we call this dorsocaudal, dorsocaudal coronary groove. Dorsocaudal left coronary groove. Dorsocaudal left coronary groove. Here, another groove. This is called as, yes, ventral caudal
groove.
Ventral caudal left coronary groove. Okay?
Yes.
Come here. Here. This one. Dorsal caudal. Yes. Coronary groove. This one. Ventral caudal
right
good coronary groove. Point is that, listen again carefully, on the both side of rumen, left and right,
yes,
left and
right,
we have grooves. We have
grooves.
Grass appearance. The middle one is known as longitudinal groove. If this is on the right side, right longitudinal groove. If on the left side,
left
longitudinal groove. Same here. And other story is that we also have two other groups, which is called caudal and
cranial
groove. Caudal and or cranial end. Listen carefully. Grass, in a grass appearance, we have grooves. We have
grooves,
and also we have sacs. So this area will be called as dorsal sac. This area will be called as
dorsal sac.
This area, ventral, using V, ventral, sac, here. No, leave left and right. Just this is dorsal, sac. Here down is here is
ventral
sac. These two sacs is called blind sacs. This is called as
blind
sacs. This is will be called as dorsocaudal. Dorsocaudal blind sac. This is will be called as dorsocaudal blind sac. This will be called as ventral caudal blind sac. Here, same name. Dorso, D for dorso, C for caudal, blind sac. Here, ventro caudal
blind
sac. Point is that grossly, if you open a cavity on left side and right side, generally we have two structures. First we see the rumen is divided into sacs. Mainly we have dorsal sac, ventral sac, dorsocaudal blind sac and ventral caudal blind sacs. Clear? And we have some grooves. We have some grooves which are called as caudal groove, cranial groove, longitudinal groove, dorsal coronary grooves, ventral caudal coronary grooves. Clear?
Yes.
You know, this is the somehow some basic point which you can observe with naked eye. Which you can observe with
naked eye.
Clear? If you look on the internal structure of rumen, if you look on the just we are talking about rumen, the pouch, the largest part. Okay. Externally we have grooves and
sac.
If you cut out and go inside, you will find what? Look here. These areas which are you are calling grooves. Which you are calling
grooves.
These grooves are now called as internally they have a muscular prominent fold. Mucosal fold inside you can view with your naked eyes. So this structure, same structure, will called as pillar. Will which called as
pillar?
P-I-L-L-A-R. Okay, mucosal pillar. Mucosal
pillar.
Same. The name also have same. This will called as longitudinal pillar. This will called as this will called as coronary pillar. This will called as coronary pillar. So here also you will find a caudal pillar. Here you will find a cranial pillar. Point is that the thing you are observing outside, which you are giving the name as groove, they are actually depression. Because of that depression, if you open this inside of that same story, you will find a pillar of projections, a fold, a uplift. Something is like this, okay? So that area is called as same location. This will called as longitudinal pillar. Actually, this you need to understand, some depression means something is going folding inside. And when you open it looking from inside, you will find this is no, as some sort of pillar, some sort of
pillars.
So internal grass structure. Internal grass structure, you will have some pillar in the rumen. You will have
some pillar in the rumen.
External grass structure, you will have grooves. And internal
pillars.
Internal grass structure, you will have
pillars.
And also, you will have one thing more, which is actually not as much as clear with naked eye. They are actually called as papilla. They are actually called as because this rumen, the most of part of rumen is lined with a special type of epithelium. Looks little some microscopic anatomy. That epithelium is known as I think we need a break for 5 minutes.
Yes.
Pause karein isko. I feel like this.